Hi, I'm Veronica Wasek, and I help Shopify sellers to set up, organize, and streamline their financial systems. Whether you're looking for DIY, done with you, or done for you bookkeeping and integrations. And in this video, I'm going to talk about the five warning signs you're not doing your Shopify bookkeeping right in QuickBooks Online. So you're a Shopify seller, you're using QuickBooks Online, you want to take advantage of integrations and automation. Unfortunately, a lot of things can go wrong, so I'm going to talk about the five things that you're probably not doing right in your QuickBooks Online. Number one, net deposits from payment processors. So when I work with Shopify merchants, I usually see that we have people either using apps to integrate Shopify and QuickBooks Online, and some of you who are not. So first of all, I'm going to talk to the ones who are not using an integrator app. So you're trying to keep things simple. You're recording all of your deposits from Shopify and your payment processors as income into your QuickBooks. Unfortunately, what that's doing is just recording one line item in your profit and loss for income. But the reality is that if you look at the Shopify finances summary, there are multiple line items on that summary. And those line items need to be reflected on your profit and loss. So whether it's Shopify income, returns, refunds, sales taxes collected, shipping income, and gift card transactions, all of that should be shown separately, actually, on your profit and loss and on your balance sheet. So by recording net deposits, you're not getting a true picture of your profitability. Number two, integrations gone wrong. Now I'm going to talk to those of you who are taking advantage of integrations and automation. Unfortunately, what happens is that we see a lot of detailed transactions being added from Shopify into QuickBooks Online. So here's how it all starts. You go into Shopify, you look at the Shopify App Store, and you find a random integration between Shopify and QuickBooks Online. It may even be the integration from QuickBooks that says it does the integration between Shopify and QuickBooks. Unfortunately, most of those apps are just going to send over detailed transactions and will end up just doing a giant data dump into your books. So then what happens is when you look at your QuickBooks, you'll see just, it could be hundreds, maybe thousands of individual sales receipts that are cluttering your books. And then you have no way to be able to reconcile or apply all of those individual transactions to the net deposits that you're getting from your payment processors. And unfortunately, there's really not a good way to reconcile those in the box. So the way to fix that is to use an integrator app that's bringing over summarized transactions from Shopify into your QuickBooks, and that allows you to then be able to have a more streamlined way of reconciling the sales made to the deposits received from payment processors. Number three is duplicated income. So for those of you who are using those integrator apps, your app is recording income into your QuickBooks Online, but then what you're probably doing is going into the bank feeds in QuickBooks Online and recording the amounts received from your payment processors also into income. We see this a lot with PayPal in particular. So now you have income recorded from your app and income recorded from the deposit from the payment processor. So again, duplicating your income. So the way to fix that is, first of all, is to have a good workflow. Understanding what is the app doing to your books, how is it recording income, and now how are we going to address the income that's being received from your payment processors, and what is the proper way to record it into your books so that you're not duplicating. Usually that's done through clearing accounts. So clearing accounts are used as a way to then be able to reconcile the sales made from Shopify to the amounts received from your payment processors. And I will link for you a video explaining more about what clearing accounts are. Number four, clearing account balances that keep growing. So let's say that you are using those clearing accounts, or the app that you're using is recording balances to clearing accounts, but suddenly those clearing account balances just keep growing and growing and they're not going away. This is actually related to what I talked about before, that duplicated income, because now you have your integrator app recording transactions into your clearing accounts and those balances keep growing, but you're not recording the deposits that you're receiving from your payment processors against those growing balances in your clearing accounts. And you're probably also not recording your payment processor fees. So how do we fix that? Well, we have to have a good workflow for offsetting the deposits received from payment processors against the balances in the clearing accounts. And number five, inventory and cost of goods sold. I see this a lot. Inventory balances are either wrong, they're never updated, and then cost of goods sold balances just sort of go up and down, and the problem is that you never have a true picture of your profitability, and then when it comes time to do your taxes, your tax preparer is going to probably point out to you that you need to update your inventory balance and that your cost of goods sold isn't correct. When doing the accounting for inventory and recording those balances, there are a lot of different buckets that you have to pay attention to. And when I say buckets, I mean different categories. So that may mean identifying what goes into inventory, what goes into inventory in transit, so inventory that you haven't received yet. It may be inventory you have paid for, inventory you haven't paid for yet. It could be advances to vendors for inventory you haven't received. And so we have to make sure that all of those different types of transactions are identified so that they can be recorded properly. Then you also have to address landed cost. Landed cost is the entire cost, the full cost that it takes for you to purchase inventory. So it may be the inventory cost, it may be freight, it could be duties, and any other fees that you're incurring to receive your inventory. And your landed costs are probably now going up. So you have to have a good process to calculate that, either using spreadsheets or using an inventory management system to be able to get a good and accurate amount for landed cost. And as I mentioned before, the problems that we end up seeing on the books is that inventory balances aren't accurate, and then cost of goods sold just goes up and down and is not giving you a true picture of profitability. So how do you know if you have these problems on your books? Or what if you see these problems and you're aware of them, but you need help? I highly encourage you to work with an experienced Shopify bookkeeping professional. Shopify bookkeeping is very different from other types of bookkeeping. You have to really know and understand sales channels, payment processors, clearing accounts, inventory, and really know how to work with all of those different types of transactions. So by working with an experienced Shopify accounting professional, they can help to diagnose your books, come up with a plan for cleaning up your books, and then to get you on the right track, whether you want to continue to do the books yourself or whether you want to work with them. Let me know in the comments if you've seen any of these problems in your books. I'd love to hear about it. I'm Veronica Wasek. Are you ready to work with a trusted and reliable Shopify accounting pro? Then check the description below to learn more about my services and how we might work together. If this content is helping you, then subscribe to my channel, ring the bell, and give me a thumbs up. And check the description below for all of my free resources, including my free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint and the link to join my Facebook community. I'll see you next time.